indigenous knowledge systems must be part of all the solutions, or as many of the solutions as we can.
That even scientists, the technical people, are beginning to understand that you need to go down there, you need to go to the community.
So as a guide to our conversation this morning, we will hear from Ricardo and Nancy. So live from 1 week after their being in Noumea, just immersed in that space.
We still have a lot to do and can do in the space and time that we have. The format for today is going to be very simple. Both Ricardo and Nancy will do an intro, talk a little bit about, just summarize the experience, then we move straight into question and answers.
The oceans are in trouble, and then a lot of the ordinary people don't understand the importance ocean plays in our lives and why it's important that we address the health of the ocean. So yeah, a lot of the issues around our failure to understand the science is because scientists haven't communicated clearly, journalists do not understand the science, therefore there's that gap that's there. Our first impression of what was emerging from the discussion last week was that the Pacific has solutions for global issues. And especially when it comes to oceans, there are already things that we know and we are doing that scientists and the policymakers haven't really capitalized on or understood the importance of. Pacific indigenous knowledge systems must be part of all the solutions, or as many of the solutions as we can. So integrating what our forefathers and what our, you know, our communities already know about mitigation and response to climate change issues.
Many policies have been developed without any consultation with people or connection to the people whose lives depend on that policy. And I think, you know, in moving forward, we need to look back and check those policies. If that's going to be used as the baseline for where we are today, we need to check how were those policies developed, what do they mean to the people whose lives depend.
And it was really stressed out that our ocean is in trouble, and we all need to work together, not only scientists, even scientists. At that meeting, they admitted that they cannot do this alone. They need the help of civil societies, NGOs, the government, communities to help in restoring the ocean's health. The technical people are beginning to understand that you need to go down there, you need to go to the communities. The communities need to be aware. They need to know the terms that we use. Most times, I mean, take for instance, if you take a report, a scientific report to a community, would they understand that? And that is how they think.
For us, we also need to recognize that race and awareness is not a one-way thing. Mm. We also need to understand and recognize that when we work with communities who use the ocean as their livelihood and things like that, we have to recognize that they also have knowledge, existing knowledge, rich existing knowledge that they can raise awareness, raise our awareness on traditional practices of using the ocean. And I think that is something that we cannot keep assuming that we are the experts just because we've done research. We need to move away from that thinking and start recognizing as well how the communities are contributing to this.
Scientists, yes, science has a role and has an important role, but it was pointed out that a lot of times the scientists don't see the value in traditional knowledge systems, and when they actually do, they can see a lot of the links that they can capitalize on there.
So where we want to land with this is for us to just again remind ourselves that our work in Oxfam in the Pacific, as well as the whole of the region, it's around addressing inequality, right? And inequality is a key driver of poverty.